Iraba siki la baha. Rokaba sekele ba sende hikigaha. Kekaya baba. Keko sukuya baha siyaha. God bless you for watching. Just worship the Lord wherever you are. Just thank Him for your life. Just enjoy the presence of the Lord wherever you are. Rate pale basiki ya haha. Ikindia basuti dikada haha. Oh yes, Lord, we love you, Jesus. Haha. Hey, yakaba haha. Haha. Hey, asika ya ba, asika ya ba. Oh yes, Lord. Oh yes, Lord. Oh yes, Lord. Ha. Hey, apa ya baba. Hiya baba, sikende ya baba. Oh yes, Lord. Ikete kete kababa. Sumbahinda ha gadosia ha. Ikaya basonti ya gadosia ha. Yes, Lord, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Ha ha. Hey. Ha. Ha ha. Oh my God. Just worship the Lord wherever you are. Just worship the Lord. Enjoy His presence. Oh my God. Just close your eyes and just worship. Just worship. Ha. Hey, Jesus. Hey. Ropa la baba sete ya baba. Hinde lebo sogaha. Just worship. Worship. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I just want to worship. I just want to get lost in His presence. I just want to get lost in His presence. Ah. Yes, Lord. We are lost without you. Hey. Just worship. Hey. Oh, I need to start this from the beginning. Ah, yeah, yeah. Hey, hey, hey. Oh, my God. Oh, yes, Lord. Just worship wherever you are. Just think about Jesus right now. Just think about Jesus right now. Don't be distracted. God is everywhere. See, this atmosphere that you're in, you can decide if you want to feel His presence or if you want to feel a negative presence. I choose to feel the presence of God. Even the air that you breathe. See, you can just feel Him in the atmosphere. Yes, all over, wherever you are. He's everywhere. If you decide to focus right now and just relax and just believe that God is where you are right now, His presence is there with you. Suddenly you will start to feel chills. You will start to feel love. You will start to feel His presence. He will even begin to communicate with you. Because you have set your mind for Him. Yes, you have set your mind to receive. Your heart is set right for Him. To receive Him. Ha! Oh yes, Lord. Ha ha! You even begin to smile. That room that you were in, that you thought you were alone. No, 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 no. You're not alone. God is there. He fills up. His presence fills up the room. Yes. There's no way you can even hide from His presence. Ha! Hey! Oh, yes, Lord. I love you, Jesus. Ora seka ya ba sonti lega ha, hira ra ra ba usha ya, and suddenly you will start to feel peace. You will feel peace of mind. And somebody, he's telling you right now, he said, I am here with you. I am here with you. I hear it so clearly. He says, he's telling you, I am here with you. Ha. Oh. Ha ha. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Enjoy the presence of God. He says He is there with you. Ha ha ha. Oh yes, Lord. Stop complaining and begin to worship. Begin to praise. Get lost in His presence. He says, I am here with you. Oh yes, Lord. Hira sota yabaha. Hire kala hanebo siya. Retete yabaha sundiya. Thank you for your presence, Lord. Thank you for being here with me. Thank you for going everywhere with me. Oh yes, Lord, I love you. Ratata ya baba. Oh Jesus. Ah. Ho ho. He has eyes everywhere. He has ears everywhere. You can't run away from him. He's everywhere. Where you are right now, he's there. Ha. Ratata ya ba sondia. Rekele ba shoka. Ire soba ha ha. Just enjoy the presence of God. Enjoy the presence of God. And my God. You will begin to feel the love of God. It's that kind of love that you can't even explain. Oh, yes. The atmosphere is filled with love. The love of God. Peace. Joy. Ha! Oh my God. I love you, Jesus. Just worship the Lord. Hey! Hey! Yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Ay, ay, ay. Hey, hey, hey. Ura baba sindia baba. Ire se ya ha katoba ha. Ura ba se keleba shonte ya ha. Ire debo sindia baba ha. Worship your Father. He is there with you. He says he is everywhere. You can even do your hand like this. Like this, and you will still feel his presence. Even when you breathe, you feel his presence. You just feel his presence everywhere. Yes. Oh, hey. Once you begin to acknowledge his presence, that evil presence you were feeling will disappear, will fade away. That's right. Once you begin to feel the presence of God, you begin to acknowledge his presence, that evil, intimidating presence will fly away. Thank you, Jesus. I'm so happy right now. Oh, yes, Lord, you are everywhere. You are everywhere, Lord. Yes, Lord. There's no need to go looking for God. God is there with you. Where are you going to look for him? Where? When he's right there with you. You can ask him, Father, are you here with me? And you will hear it clearly. Yes. Yes. Somebody just ask that question. If you don't believe, just do it anyway. Say, Father, are you here with me? Just ask that question. Father, are you here with me? Father, are you here with me? Father, are you here with me? He will say, yes, my child, I am here with you. Yes, she is right. I am here. I'm everywhere. I follow you wherever you go. I have never left you. I will never leave you. Hey! Oh my God. He said you need to acknowledge him more. You need to acknowledge him more. And then you will feel more of his presence. So wherever you go, Father, I know you are here with me. Thank you for following me here. Thank you for your presence. Acknowledge him more and you will begin to feel his presence more in your life. But if you don't acknowledge him, then you will not even know he's there with you. Well, some of you will even start to cry when you ask him that question. Father, are you here? You will hear clearly, yes, I am here with you. Oh, I love you, Jesus. You run so much. You run everywhere to go look for God, to go hear from God. When God, he's saying he's there with you, you can just speak to him. Because he has ears everywhere. He has eyes everywhere. He hears. So you think you're speaking to yourself, but no. God is listening to you. Hey. Oh. This atmosphere has changed. There's no negativity when you are in the presence of God. There's no anger. There's no fear. There's no sadness. There's no depression. Oh, you don't feel all of those negative stuff. You just feel so much joy, so much peace and love. Easy to forgive. Always smiling. Peaceful. Peaceful, no worries in his presence. Ha. Oh, Jesus. Just worship your Father. Some of you, if you even feel like somebody is giving you a hug right now, if you even open your hands wide, you will receive a hug from your Father. You will just feel like somebody just hugged you right now. You will even begin to cry. Oh. Ayayaya. You didn't know what was here. Hikaya kaya ba. Zete ya baba. Hide kaya kundi ya baba. Ora diga da was here. Hide kaya hotsu palika ya. Hide kaya kato was here. Hikaya ba. I love you, Father. Oh, Jesus, I love you. He's everywhere. He's there with you. Huh? Oh, yes, Lord. Kekaya bosa kaya ya ya. Oh, Jesus. Thank you for your presence, Lord. Thank you for giving me a hug. Thank you for giving me peace. Thank you for filling my heart with love. Osikaya Baba, just worship your Father. Raise up your hand and worship your Father. Hirakati, nothing else matters right now. When you're in the presence of God, nothing else matters right now. Retelebo sikaya baba. Hirekotundia Baba. Some of you will be crying as you worship your Father. You will not even understand why you are crying. Because the presence is so strong in this place. Wherever you are, be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. You will have chills all over your body. Chills all over your body. That pain is no more there. It's gone. You don't even feel it anymore. Because you are in the presence of God. How can you feel that pain when you are in the presence of your Father? You don't even care what anyone thinks of you right now. You're just in the presence of your Father. You just want to be lost. Yeah. You even speak new tongue. Some of you will just be flowing in tongue. You won't even be able to stop it. It will just be flowing. Your tongue is just rolling. You will speak new tongues. You will feel lighter. You will feel relieved. It's like something heavy just left you. I say God is everywhere. This atmosphere has changed. I feel this presence so strong. Worship your Father. Why are you so proud to worship it? Get on your knees and worship. Raise up your hand. Don't be feeling too sophisticated. Don't be feeling too important. You need to humble yourself in the presence of God. Humble yourself before your Father and just worship Him. Don't worry about anything else right now. Don't worry about the bills. Don't worry about what somebody said about you. That doesn't even matter. That's to make you upset. That's to make you angry. You don't need that right now. Oh, yes, Lord. Just worship. It's coming from your belly. As you are speaking the tongue, it's coming straight from your stomach. Your belly. Some of you will be rocking back and forth. Some of you will be crying, confessing your sins to your Father. Some of you will say, Lord, I didn't even know you were just here with me. I thought you were far away from me. But now I know that you are right here with me. You are not far away from me, Lord. I will begin to acknowledge you more, Lord. I will begin to talk to you more. I will begin to listen more to you, Lord. Hey! 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 Yes, Lord! Yes, Lord! I love you, Jesus! Ha! And I love you, Jesus! Hey! Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh, Oh, Jesus, I love you. I love you, Jesus. Oh, forgive me for thinking that you are so far away from me. Tell him, forgive me, Lord, for thinking that you are far away from me. Forgive me for going everywhere to look for you when you are just right here with me, Lord. I'm sorry. Retayababa. Now be drunk in the Holy Ghost. Wherever you are, be drunk in the Holy Ghost. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. Those that desire to speak in tongues, receive the gift of tongues right now. Receive it in the name of Jesus. A fresh fire is coming over you. Receive it. A fresh anointing. Receive that anointing right now. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive power. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Some of you will start to be shaking. You'll be shaking. You'll be vibrating. Hey! 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 I love you, Jesus. Hey! 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 Oh my God! Hey! Hey! Jesus! Oh! Somebody will say, oh, this lady is crazy. That's fine. I don't really care what you think right now. I don't really care what you think. If only you can feel what I'm feeling. Oh, yes. Oh, I am crazy in love with my Father. Yes, that's right. Oh, yes. Oh, oh, I love you, Jesus. Just tell him you love him. Say, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Jesus. Oh, I can't stop saying it. I love you, Jesus. And I'm not ashamed to say this. I will say it everywhere I go. Let the world hear it. I am not ashamed of you, Father. I love you. I need more of your presence, Lord. More, Lord. More, Holy Spirit. More. Tell him more. Say more. Everybody type more. More. I need more. More. Keep asking for more and you will receive more. I need more of you. I want more of you. More. More. Everybody type more. More. I want more. Oh, yes, Lord. Rekayababa, Sintiyababa. Some of you will begin to laugh in the Holy Ghost. Some of you will be crying in the Holy Ghost. Some of you will be just happy. Some of you will be speaking loud. Oh, yes, Lord. Some of you will be running around the house. Some of you are kneeling down. Some of you are jumping up. Some of you don't even know how you feel right now. You can't explain this feeling right now. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, I need more. I need more. More of you. More of your presence, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Give me more, Lord. More. 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 Hey. Shakalaba, sekelababa. Idebababa, sonte ya baba. Hey, ayababa. Yekanaba sonte ya baba. Ile de debo siya kadosia ha. Rante la baba. Iteka ya ya ya. Obasi kele bo sonte ya la baba osia ha. Ha. I need more. That's right. Ha. 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 Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yeah, Kapuli Katika Rabo, Sikine Leba Sente, Rekete Yakadia Baha. Oh, yes, Lord, I love you. Oh, my God. Yes, Lord, I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Oh, my Father. Rekelebosia. Oh, my God. Wow. Hey. 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 Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Don't stop worshiping. Hey, and Rekelebosia. Hira baba sekele baba. The corner of the bow see ya ha ha ha. You got a bow see ke ya baha nehe. Ogandi ya ha ha. Hey! I love you, Father. Oh! I just want to be lost in your presence. I want to be lost in your presence. I want to be lost in your presence. I want to be lost in your presence, Lord. I want to be lost in your presence. Hide pola baha. None of us see a hand. Oh, my Father. My Father, my Father. Rekete baba. Ronto lobo shiaha. Oh, my God. I feel so good right now. I just feel so good right now. Ah. Oh. Oh, my God. Oh, my mama. Oh, my God. Yakata ya baba. Oh, my baba. Sika da baba. Oh, papa, 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 papa. Kakati kata baba. Ikonto lobo sige de baba. KKK kaka 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 kaka. Oh, Jesus, I love you. Oh, my God. I feel so good. I feel so good. How is everybody feeling right now? Even your face will change. Everything will change. You will begin to glow. You will feel more relaxed, more peaceful. That depression look, that sad look will just leave you right now. That angry look, because this atmosphere has changed. The love of God has taken over you. The peace of God. Yes, the joy. Everything has taken over you right now. You that was frowning your face earlier. You that was stressed earlier. Now you feel so relaxed. You look, your face even changed. You look peaceful. You look even more beautiful. Yeah. You don't look stressed right now. You don't feel stressed. You feel light. Like something was lifted off of you. Like something left you. Like something jumped out of you. You understand what I mean? It's like something came out and something good came in. The Spirit of God took over. Ayaya. Oh my God. I love Him so much. Yes. 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 Oh my God. There's a scripture that I posted on the video. I don't know if you guys saw it. Let me read it for you guys. Wow. This is Jeremiah 23:23 and 24, really. It says, am I a God who is only close at hand? Says the Lord. Am I a God who is only close at hand? He said, no, I'm far away at the same time. Meaning, I'm here with you very close, but I'm also far. Meaning, I'm just everywhere. Simple. It says, can anyone hide from me in a secret place? Am I not everywhere in all the heavens and earth, says the Lord? Is there anyone that can hide from Him? How can you hide from Him when even the air you breathe, He's there? Like, it's everywhere. Can't you see His presence all over the place? Can't you feel Him? Can't you just feel Him? You even go into a dark room, just picture the presence of, just picture what I'm telling you, that God is there with you. See, God is a spirit. So yes, He's everywhere. He said you can't hide from His presence. You can't hide from Him. Even if you go under the bed, He's there. He's in the air. Like, He's everywhere. Can you hide? Like, where can you hide from Him? Do you understand what I'm saying? So if you're always thinking God is so far away from me, God is not listening to me, I don't think my prayers are being answered, I don't even know if God hears me, I don't even know. Don't do that. When you do that, It means that you don't know he's everywhere. He said he's everywhere. Even as you are now, this air, the air you're breathing now, is in that air that you just breathe. He's, even raise your hand and do something like this. Somebody, all of you, do this with me. Do this with me. Do this by faith. Raise your hand up like this. And do like you're trying to clear the cloud or something. And you will feel chills. You will feel his presence on that hand. Because he's in that atmosphere. You're just, how do they say, you're basking in the presence of God. Like the chills you feel is all over the room. So that's God. That's God everywhere. If you put your hand like this and you do like you want to clear something, you will feel chills on that hand. That means it's everywhere, right? You breathe like this, you will feel him. He's everywhere. The air you breathe is everywhere. So when you know that he's so present like that, why are you afraid? Why are you afraid? Why? Why are you afraid? That thought of fear should not even come near you, knowing that God is there with you. Even when you are driving, he's in the car with you. His presence is going with you in the car. You can just smile and say, Father, I know you are here with me. You're about to sleep. Father, I know you are here. I can feel your presence in this room. I know you are here with me. Before you know, even right now, some of you, you just feel the presence, like your house, the atmosphere in your house has changed. It's like you can almost touch him. I don't know how to explain this. It's like you can, see, anytime I do a program, ask anybody that has been there, they can feel the tangible, the presence of God. Somebody say it's almost like you could just scoop it with a spoon. The presence is so heavy. It's so strong. So strong. You can make that happen with you. You can always change the atmosphere. If you're feeling a negative presence, you can change the atmosphere and just begin to speak to the atmosphere. You say, hey, you devil of fear or whatever you are, I command you to leave right now. I know God is here in this presence, in this atmosphere. I know my angels are here. I know Jesus is here with me. I can feel his presence already. Boom. Immediately, that fear that you had, that atmosphere that seemed so demonic, like a demon was there, it will just change. You will start to smile to a peaceful atmosphere. You will just begin. Somebody will think you're going crazy, but you're not. It changes just like that. In a few seconds. But it's up to you. It's up to you for that to change. It's up to you if you want it to change. Oh my God. Oh my God. He says he is everywhere. He says, can anyone hide from me in a secret place? Am I not everywhere in all the heavens and the earth? I am everywhere. When you think you are alone in a place, oh, I am there. You can speak to me and I will answer. You can call on me and I will answer. You can just meditate. In fact, in a place where you think that nobody is there with you, that's even where you will feel the presence of God more. Find that secret place, that place where nobody is. In fact, go to the park where there's nobody in the park, only you. You would think you're alone. That's where you even feel him so much. You will feel his presence so much. You will hear so clearly. Go where there's only trees and whatever, flowers. You will even almost hear him audibly. You will hear him and there's nobody there but just you. But you will feel him more than before. So when you think you're alone and there's nobody there, that's where you even get to feel his presence more. That's when you hear from him even more. That's when you can talk to him more. Like, I'm telling you. So don't be thinking you're alone. I'm alone in this world. I don't have anybody. Even God has abandoned me. No. God doesn't abandon his own. Never. Never. He will never forsake you. He will never leave you. He is always with you. Oh, I love you, Jesus. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Wow. Diana said, wow. I just read this in a book, taking authority over negative atmosphere and replacing it with God's virtue and making it positive. Hallelujah. You see what I'm saying? I didn't even know there's something in a book like that. This is strictly from the Holy Spirit telling me. You can enter a room that has a dark presence and you can begin to speak to the atmosphere. You're like, see you devil, I'm not afraid of you. Now I command this atmosphere to change now in the name of Jesus. Pack your things and go, you evil spirit. Oh Lord, take over this place. I want to feel your presence like never before. Jesus, take over this place. I know my angels are here. Suddenly you will start to feel chills. You have now taken charge of... See, that's what I do whenever I do program. When I enter that place, I own that atmosphere. I take charge of it. I change the atmosphere. That's why you see people in the spirit, people cry. That's why evil spirit cannot stay. They will go and hide or they will... It's too charged for them. Ha-ha! Ha ha ha! Yay! Ha ha ha! That's the atmosphere for miracles. Before you know, people are getting healed. Before you know, people are speaking in tongues. People are crying. People are rolling on the floor. People are, they don't even know what's happening. The presence of God is just so strong in that place. That's right. Ha ha ha! Yay! Ha ha ha! Oh! My God, I love that scripture. It says, can anyone hide from me in a secret place? Where do you consider a secret place? I'm even there more. That's why when you're doing evil things, thinking nobody is seeing you, oh, God has eyes everywhere. He sees what you're doing. If you're doing that thing that you know it's evil and your conscience is telling you don't do it, and you look around, is anyone seeing you? That's just the physical people you're looking for. God is a spirit. He sees you. He's just there watching you. Yeah, even if you turn off the light and you want to do something bad, thinking it's so dark, nobody can see you. Oh no, God sees you. You are only fooling people. You are only running from people. But you can't fool God. He sees you. He hears you. Even when you are not speaking, He hears what your heart is saying. Like, He knows your thoughts. This God is too powerful. I can't even describe this God. I don't even know how best to describe Him. He's just too powerful. He's just everywhere. He's loving. He's merciful. Let me tell you what happened. While I was just speaking in tongues before I came on Facebook, because I woke up and I just said, the first thing I said is, Father, you are everywhere. You are here with me. And whenever I say that, I start to smile. I say, Father, you are everywhere. Even at night when I was sleeping, the devil was trying to attack me with the spirit of masturbation or something. Before you know, I was sleeping and suddenly it's like I saw my hand trying to touch myself. I woke up and I rebuked that thing. I said, not today. Out in the name of Jesus. I said, out. Father, your presence. I want your presence to fill up this atmosphere. I want this evil presence to leave right now. In the name of Jesus. And I slept well. So when I woke up today, I was like, Father, you are everywhere. I feel you. I smell you. It's like I can touch you. I don't know, but this is me. I started speaking in tongues and just speaking in tongues, playing this song, because this is a song that keeps coming to me. This is a song that keeps playing in my spirit. Before you know, guess what? Somebody I did deliverance for last night. That the demon was saying that they got her from, that her mother went to get her from the river or something. That's how she came. That her mother came to the river to get her. And I don't know if you guys remember this deliverance. I did it early this morning in the other video where they say she was always baiting with, what's it called? She was always baiting with the water from the river until when she was of age. She says, no, she's not doing it anymore. She refused it. She sent me a message. While I was speaking in tongues, I was just smiling, enjoying the presence of my Father. I was just filled with love. I was just in a good mood right now. I'm telling you that before I came on the video. She said, good evening, woman of God. Thank you so much for praying for me yesterday. God bless you. I watched my video. Thank God I am free. I'm waiting to get my first check so I can sow my seed. And listen, guys. You see how all these evil agents, they come to spoil what God has done for you. She said, one of my friends just called me and she called you names. Her friend called and was calling me names. Me that did the deliverance on her. She said, one of my friends just called me and she called you names, getting angry. Why I don't know how to pray for myself. That Nigerian pastors will be the last pastor she will go to ever, even on her dying bed, because I am fake. Like she said, because me, I am fake. That why is she going to meet a Nigerian pastor to pray for her? That even when she's on her dying bed, she would never come to a Nigerian pastor because they are fake. She said, I blocked her number on my phone. And the next one is Facebook. I am going to block her. But me, I was busy praying in tongues, just smiling, ha, enjoying the presence of my Father. You know what I told her? I said, forgive her. Hey, retable. This woman call me fake, call me this. But guess what? When you are in that presence, when you are lost in his presence, when you are just enjoying the presence of God, forgiveness is so easy. I say, she's watching now. She can come on and she will tell you it's true. I say, I say, forgive her. While that one is over there getting mad that somebody is free, calling me names that I'm fake, I am here telling this one, forgive her. That's what the presence of God can do to you. That's what God does to people. When you are in the spirit, forgiving is so easy. When you are in the spirit, all these things don't even bother you. Whatever they say is like, okay, no problem. And it didn't end there. God started to speak to me when I told her, forgive her. She said, okay, woman of God, I will forgive her. But I don't want to get friendly with her right now. I don't want no negative people in my life. And this is what I heard from God. And I typed it. I said, the devil wants you to get angry again so he can enter. The devil wants you to get angry again so he can enter. That's what he does. He will send somebody, an agent to you, to say things to annoy you. And you will get so angry with that agent. And before you know it, the spirit of anger will come back in. That's what he was trying to do. He wanted the girl to piss her off, to say things to piss her off. And then she will start getting angry. She just got delivered early this morning. And now the devil sends people to come and get her upset. And she will get angry. Why are you saying this? Why are you doing that? Don't call me again. You are this, you are that. Get so angry. And the devil said, that's exactly what I wanted. Boom. It will enter again. He knows what he's doing. It's not even about the friend that called her. It's about her getting, going back to where she's coming from. They want to enter her. So they do things to get her upset. They do things to open a door so that they can come in with 7 more or 8 more or 10 more with stronger demons. This is what God told me. He said, the devil wants you to get angry again so we can enter. So just tell them, thanks and God bless you. Hey, you want me to show it to you? Right here. I said, just tell them. I was still praying in tongues though. I was still enjoying the presence of my Father. I was like what they said about me, I don't really care. I'm talking to God right now. And what God is saying about me is totally different from what that person is saying. So that person's opinion doesn't really count. In fact, that person is already forgiven. Hey! I said, just tell them thanks and God bless you. Thanks and God bless you. I say thanks and God even bless them. Bless them. I say bless them. That's not what the devil was expecting. That's not what the devil was expecting. The devil was expecting somebody to be angry, somebody to say some curse word, somebody to go and block and do this and do that and say, don't call me anymore. I hate you. You are even the one that did this to me. Oh, no, we don't need that. You are free. Stay free. Start to live like Jesus. Start to forgive. Start to love people. No problem. Thank you. God bless you. And say it from your heart. Don't fake it. Don't say it because you just want something written on the paper. Say it from your heart. God bless you. Mean it. Because you know it's not them speaking to you at that point. It's the devil using somebody that has made themselves available for him to speak through them. Remember Job, when Job was going through all that and he started having all those boils all over his body, the devil used his wife and spoke through his wife to Job. Say, why are you still trying to love God? Are you still trying to maintain your integrity? Why don't you just curse God and die? He knew that this wasn't even the wife speaking. That was the devil using her mouth to speak. Because he knows that it will hurt him coming from the wife. It was not even about the woman. The woman herself was grieving. She lost all her kids. She lost everything. So it's easy to forgive the woman. I forgive you, woman. But don't speak like the foolish people anymore. Don't let the devil speak through you like this. God bless you. That's right. Especially when you just get deliverance. When I come here, spend time on you, pray for you, you get delivered. Oh, they're going to call you. A lot of them will call you. Yeah, because these people are not born again. They are not saved. They don't have the Spirit of God. So they are just open to the devil. So he can manipulate them anyhow. He can use their mouth to say anything. Sometimes they don't even mean what they said. I'm telling you, they love you from their heart, but it's just at that point, something is speaking through them. Forgive them, because they don't really hate you. It's not everybody that says negative stuff to you that hates you. It's that evil spirit that is causing it. They don't hate you. They don't hate you. It's a spirit that is controlling them, making it seem like they hate you, making them seem like they are not happy for you. When that spirit is out, you will see this person. That the same one that said something like that, that upset you, is the same one that is going to be blessing you and praying for you. So it's not even about them. The enemy here is the devil. The enemy is the devil. He's the one that is upset. He's the one that wants to get you to the point that you don't want to get to no more. So he will use people that you think will celebrate with you, people that will make you happy, people that you think will support you. He will use them to turn against you. He will use them to say things to you that you don't expect to hear, because he knows it's only close people that can do that to you that it will piss you off. He's not going to use an outsider to tell you stuff. You don't care what an outsider says. It's not going to hurt you. You don't even know the outsider. He will use somebody like Job. The devil used his wife to say that to him. He will use somebody. Oh, yes, Lord. He will use somebody that you least expect. Somebody that you thought is your friend. Somebody that you thought will be happy for you. Somebody. And you will now know that it's not this one that is speaking. It is the devil, because he's angry. He's mad. He wants to get you back to that place so he can come in and attack again. So he can come and finish whatever he started. But no, you know better now. You are a child of God. You are a child of love. See, God is love. So once you surrender to God, you should be able to love. You should be able to easily forgive. You should be able to really mean it when you say, I love you. You should not be living in pretense, trying for people to approve of you. No, like me, when I come on Facebook doing my thing, I don't care what nobody says. If I'm speaking in tongues, I don't care what anybody says. I'm just listening to the Holy Ghost. I'm in my own world. I'm not even here with you. So anybody can say whatever. If the comments is becoming so much, I block the person so that way they're not being a distraction to my video. But I don't hate them, because most times I go back and unblock them. You can ask Pastor Isaac. I'm always unblocking people because I know it is not these people. The enemy here is not even them. It is the devil. But at that point, when they want to cause distraction, I know what they're doing. I block them for that video so that way they don't distract the rest of the people. But I don't hate them. I don't have ill feeling for them. See, think about it. Is it worth it hating somebody? How would you hate somebody and carry that kind of grudge with you and go to hell? You do everything right. Everything God says do, you do it right. And then suddenly, you find that, not you, I'm just giving you an example. You've been living right, trying to please God, only to find out one day that you couldn't make heaven because of unforgiveness. Because you were bearing grudge for somebody. One person. And you're like, what? I've brought so many people to Christ. I've done so many good things. I've helped so many people. I've stayed away from sin. how can this one thing with this one person make me to be disqualified? Was it worth it? No. I remember Philip, the guy that plays keyboard for me, in my program in Maryland 2 weeks ago, when I gave him the mic to speak, he said that he died for 3 hours in 2000 and was it 3 or 13? I'm not sure. You guys were there. You listened to it. He died for 3 hours or 2 hours. I'm not sure. Sorry, guys. I have the numbers different, but you guys know what I'm saying. So when he died, he said he saw a long line. People were going to one place. Another person was going to one place. And he was thinking he would go to heaven. But they were telling him to go to the other line that leads to hell. And he's like, he says, why am I going there? Why do I have to go to that place? I don't deserve to be in that place. I've worked so hard to be in heaven. And God told him, he said, no, you don't qualify to be in heaven. Your worship was not right while you were here. You were worshiping for God, for men to be pleased. You were not caring about me. You were doing things to please men. When men applaud you, when you were doing things to please the people that brought you to the program and not me. And also, he said, he showed him his own father in hell. And he showed him some pastors, some people he knew in hell. And then he told him, he showed him a lady. And he says, I'm going to give you one more chance to go and worship right. He said, when you go, this woman, you need to make peace with this one. That's, I think he said there was something, him and the woman were having an argument, or he was having grudge or something with that woman. And he said, go, when you go, make sure you make peace with this one. Hey, if he wasn't given a second chance, do you know he would have landed in hell? Hey, why would God point out to go make peace with one woman? So in his mind, he's doing worship. He's bringing down the presence of God. People are getting in the spirit. You can bring down the presence of God, though. Like me now, I could be a woman of God. People come to my program, feel the presence, repent. But if me, myself, my own thing is not right with God, me, myself, I won't make heaven. There is no favoritism. There is no exception. The rule applies to everyone. So yeah, I can be anointed. I can be laying hands on people. Things are happening. But if myself, I am having grudge, unforgiveness, all these things, and I'm thinking, well, God loves me. God chose me to work, so I'm okay. I don't have to forgive people. I don't have. It's a lie. I will not make heaven. So just imagine you've stayed away from fornication. You've stopped lying. You've stopped doing this. You've stopped doing all those things you used to do. But there's this one person that you refuse to forgive. This one person you refuse to forgive. You always go to church, you always pray, you pay your tithes, you do everything, you help the needy, you are just good. You have changed, but there's this one person you refuse to forgive. In your mind, I am doing well. I know definitely I will make heaven. I know definitely God is pleased with me. You have not remembered that one person that you are still bearing grudge for. Sometimes God brings it to you. Sometimes God is telling you, forgive this one. Forgive. You will just, her face will flash to you. And instead of you to forgive, you will have anger. No, never. Over my dead body. No. But you are doing everything else right. But that one has a stronghold on you. That one has a stronghold on you. But everything else you have changed. But that one, whenever you think of that one, you start to feel angry. You start to remember the incidents. You start to remember what they did to you. You say, no, that one was too much. I can't let it go. Even if I forgive self, I don't ever want to see her anymore. Like, is it worth it? You are good now. Why does one person have to have a stronghold over you like this? Let me tell you, most times that one person is not even thinking of you. That one person has moved on. That one person has a good life somewhere, enjoying themselves. You are here just suffering because of unforgiveness, because of grudge. That one person is married. having children, preaching in church, doing this. That one person probably already forgave you too. But you are the one suffering it. Every time you think of the person, your heart starts to beat fast. You start to feel a kind of sharp pain in your heart. You start to feel hurt. You start to remember everything they did. It's like it happened just yesterday. You start to speak. You that was in a good mood, suddenly, every time you remember that person, the mood changes to a negative mood. Why does one person have so much power over you like that? Why do you give them so much power? Why? You don't need that. Sometimes you may want to be praying as you are going deep, deep, deep in the spirit. The devil will flash that one person to you and you will stop praying. You will start feeling like, or sometimes you enter Facebook, you're in a good mood. You check your news feed. Somebody just shared a post from that person. Once you saw their name, you're like, why do they keep sharing that? You even get mad at the person that shared it. You block the person. The anger went from that one person and is affecting everybody around the person. You say, well, as long as you're still mingling with this one, as long as you're still talking to this one, I cannot be close to you. I cannot mingle with you. I cannot talk to you because you keep sharing their videos. I'm not going to be cool with you because you keep doing this with that. I don't want to know you. Now, it's not one person. It's now a bunch of people. It's now a bunch of people. But these people probably don't even feel that thing you feel about them. They feel good about you. You understand? They feel like they don't have anything against you. Why are you trying to go to hell? Why are you trying to go to hell? Why? It's not worth it. That's the devil. And you will not know that this is a stronghold. You will not know that this is something that needs to go. You are just focused on fornication. I don't fornicate anymore. You think that's the only sin? Or you're focused on, I don't lie anymore. Oh no, there's more to that. It's not just lying. It's not just fornicating. Little things like this counts. You need to have a pure heart, a clean heart, a heart filled with love for everyone. If somebody hates you, that's their business, but you don't hate them. If you did something to them, tell them you're sorry. Apologize. I'm sorry. Forgive me. And mean it. Don't just say it because you want to say it. Say it from your heart so that you will have peace. Now, if they don't want to accept it, that's on them. That's between them and God. You, on your part, you've done your part. You feel good about what you did. Now you can go kneel down in front of your Father and worship. Even Jesus said it, that if you're about to present a sacrifice or something to the Lord, and there's somebody that you need to make peace with, that you need to forgive, drop that offering there. Go make the peace. Come back before you start to pray. Because that prayer will not be answered. Because your heart is not pure right now. You need to be free from that stronghold. This one, you don't even need deliverance. There was a time I was preaching in Miami at my cousin, Pastor Isaac Sawa II's program. And that day, God made me narrate something that happened to me of how my assistant pissed me off. And I went off on her and she was begging all night. I didn't want to forgive her. Then the next day, I couldn't pray that night because I didn't want to forgive her. I was so mad at her. And it affected my pastor, my bishop and my cousin because I was so angry and my anger entered them too. I kind of put it on them too. That night I could not pray. But the next day I woke up, I forgave her. I went to my bishop. I said, I'm sorry. I apologize. I called my cousin. I said, I'm sorry. I apologize for overreacting. Made peace with them. And then I felt the presence of God so strong. See, just because I'm a woman of God doesn't mean the thing that you deal with, I don't deal with it. I deal with it too. And that's why I'm a good teacher, because I can use these experiences to teach you that these things happen. But we need to snap out of it. We need to know the right thing to do to get free from it. Otherwise, it starts to eat us up. It starts to destroy us and we don't even know. So when I came on that stage, I started to preach. Preaching about what happened. Telling them what happened, how I made peace with, you know, everybody, how I was able to forgive, and how everything just started feeling right. You know, I can't come on the stage holding the mic, preaching, and all these things in my mind. I don't want to do that. I want to flow. I don't want one person to be in my... See, I love all my followers, even the ones that don't love me. Because I'm not doing it because of them. I'm doing it because of me and my father. I don't want to go to hell because of one follower that pissed me off. Oh no, I forgive you, sweetie. I love you, sweetie. So now I can go and pray comfortably in my closet without something bringing your face to me and saying, you see what it... No, I don't need this. I don't need this. I want to be free. I want to make heaven. I don't want to go to hell because of one person that I don't even really know. After all this hard work, I was online yesterday for almost 7 hours. This morning, now I'm here again. Only God knows how long I'm going to be on this video. Maybe I'll do 3 videos. Maybe I'll do 4. After all this hard work, you want me to miss heaven because of one person? It's not worth it for me. So when I finished preaching that, God started speaking to me that a lot of people in that hall, they had anger, unforgiveness, and all these things. I said, okay, come out if you're dealing with this. So we can pray and you can ask God to forgive and you will let go and you'll be free. A lot of people came out. In fact, almost the whole room came out. And some of them were crying and they were forgiving. They're telling some of them right after that, they started texting people, calling people. I am sorry. I forgive you. I let it go. It's not even worth it. Do you know the moment you forgive somebody and let go, your eyes will now open. You will now say, it wasn't even worth it. It wasn't even worth it. Like, it wasn't even worth it. Like, why was I so angry? The moment you forgive, your eyes will open because the devil had closed that eyes you couldn't see before. You thought it was a big deal. You thought it was worth it. The moment you forgive, that black veil will leave your face. You will begin to see clearly. You will not say, oh my God, it was not even worth it. This anger was not even warranted. Why was I so angry? You and the person, we even start to laugh about it. I can't believe we didn't talk to ourselves for almost 2 months because of this little thing. Are you serious? We've been through even worse things than this. How can this little thing make us not speak for 2 months? It wasn't even worth it. You will start laughing about it. You will now know that it was the enemy putting this so that you can't pray well, so that you can't feel the presence of God. Do you know when you have so much of that in you, unforgiveness, grudge, and all these things, everybody is crying, feeling the presence of God. You're wondering, why am I not able to connect? What is happening? Why can't I connect? Why can't I connect? You say, woman of God, please pray for me. I need fire. I need more fire. I pray the fire still doesn't come. And you're wondering, people are here rolling on the floor, crying, worshiping. But me, I don't feel it. Something needs to leave. Yeah, let it go. That person too probably has been praying for you to call. I'm going to tell you guys a story. Let me finish this one. So a lot of people came out and I was hearing God saying they are forgiven and all that. One lady there, I'm going to use that lady as an example. Ada Jesus is her name on Facebook. She cried unforgiveness and all this stuff. The next day she came for a one-on-one in Miami. And when I was delivering her, that demon wanted to fight me. You guys watched it. And the demon said that that as of yesterday, she had the spirit of unforgiveness in her. But when she came out, after I called them to come out, and she started crying to God, that spirit left. See, I didn't do deliverance, so it was a self-deliverance. You guys watched it in the video when the demon said it. He said, as of yesterday, she had the spirit of unforgiveness at the program. But when you call them to come out, and she came out, and she started crying to God that she will forgive, she will let go, that spirit left. So the spirit now said, I am the only one here now. I am the only one left. The unforgiveness spirit has left her. Just like that. Just because she decided to let go. I didn't lay hands on her head. Just like that. The moment the spirit mission is to make you not to do something, not to forgive. The moment you forgive, he has failed. His mission has failed. So he has to leave. He can't stay. Because now you are doing that thing. He was assigned to make sure you don't forgive. His mission was make sure she doesn't forgive. But now you have forgiven. What is he still doing there? Why is he still there? He can't stay there. He has to leave. His mission failed. He did not do what his evil master told him to do, because this one has surprised him and done what God wants her to do. Let me tell you something. I don't even know why I'm talking about forgiveness, but the spirit in me is the spirit of God. He knows when people need to address something. In 2016, towards the end of 2016, you know, I started preaching August 22nd of 2000. Yes, the cleaners. Tell them to clean. Turn on the light in this passage. Tell them to go ahead and clean. They can clean. Come on, baby. Tell them that they will clean my room last. Did you tell them?
Not yet.
Tell mommy to tell them that they will clean this room last.
Not yet.
Where are they? Come on, ladies. Are they upstairs or are they starting from downstairs? They want to start from downstairs? How many of them?
Two.
Okay, tell them to start cleaning. Just turn on the light on the passage and the stairs for them. Sorry, I scheduled cleaners. My cleaners always come every 2 weeks. And it's only... They came last week, Wednesday. Today is what? Thursday. But yesterday when I entered my bathroom, it was so clean. Oh, don't get... My house is very clean. When I entered the bathroom, I started feeling like I need cleaning. So when I even text the woman, I said, I want you guys to go. She said, woman, it's not even 2 weeks yet. I said, it's okay. I want you to come clean now. I don't know, man. I just wanted it to be clean. And it's clean. I don't think they have anything to do now, Seth. Because it's not even up to how many days. But it is well. My God is a clean God. I like a clean atmosphere. I'm so happy today. So the demons started saying that the lady, the unforgiveness left. And I wanted to tell you guys a story that happened in 2016. I started preaching August, this month, August. Somebody remind me on the 21st of this month. Wesu, where are you? Make sure you remind me, sweetie. Wesu, remind me of everything. 21st of August is my 2 years that I got filled with the Holy Ghost, right? And then 22nd, the next day, is 2 years that I started preaching. Because the moment I got the Holy Ghost in 2016, the next day I heard him tell me, go online and preach. And I started preaching the next day, just like that. So this August is my second year anniversary of this ministry. So it's not like I've been doing this for 10 years. It's God that has been helping me with this thing. Because I go and I watch some of the videos that, because Wesu has been posting a lot of my old videos on YouTube. When I even listen to some of them, I'm like, how did I preach this message? This was not me. Even the way I used to speak, my accent was a little more American, but I guess I've been in my house so long doing videos, I've not been mingling with white people. My accent don't change to typical African girl. Like, nah, as I'm sounding, I sound so Nigerian. But when I first started preaching 2 years ago, I was standing like phonetic. If you don't want to do this, you can do that. But now when I'm talking now, the accent has melted away because I'm always in this house preaching. No more flick, no more like mixing with white people again. So now I don't have American accent again. The thing has disappeared. But if you watch my first videos, you will hear this sweet American accent. I watch the video and say, try, bring back my accent. I need my accent back. You know me, I like to laugh too much. It's okay. I enjoy yourself. So around that kind, August, September, October, I think November or October, a lady called me from New York. Like, she's been trying to get me. She used to follow me when I was doing parties and everything. She's been trying to get me. I was so busy then, you know, and all that. And before you know, I got to talk to her. And while I was talking to her, she said that she wants to live for God. She wants to change. She wants to be filled with the Holy Spirit. That she's seeing what I'm doing. And she's just so impressed. Because she used to see my pictures when I was, in the world and everything. I don't know if she's watching now. But she will remember this. I even posted her testimony. She used to have so many testimonies. So, while she was talking to me, God was speaking to me about her. I started hearing, I said, even gave me the name of a guy. I said, who is Emeka? Who is Emeka? She said, that's an ex-boyfriend of hers that she doesn't talk to anymore. I said, I'm hearing that name. I'm hearing that you need to forgive this guy. She said, man, that guy hurt her so bad when they were dating that she has blocked him everywhere. She has blocked his number. She has blocked him on Facebook. She has blocked him everywhere, that he really treated her bad during the relationship. I said, Michael! Hold on, guys. Let me go talk to the cleaners. There's something they need to use for my house. And I don't think my son knows where it is, okay? Let me go give it to them. Because me, if I start preaching, I'll forget everybody. Hold on, guys, okay? Enjoy this while I go quickly and come back. Oh, my God. Hello, ladies. Sorry, guys. I had to climb my bed. You know, I do my video from my bed sometimes. Okay, see my son. Oh, come here, Mikey. My son will not let me rest. Oh, hey. Wait, let me move this in my mouth. Come here. Let me tell you guys what my son is telling me. You know, yesterday I was telling you guys about a movie I watched, Miracles from Heaven, of how God started speaking to me from the movie. So Michael, today now, when I was telling him, I said, oh, I preached about the movie and I told people I watched this movie. He said, did you tell them that I was the one that picked the movie? I said, oh my God, I think I forgot to tell them. So today now, when I went downstairs to go tell the cleaners what to do, he now reminded me, he said, mommy, Did you tell them that it was me that picked the movie you watched yesterday? I said, I don't know. I said, but why do you want me to do that? I said, I just need to get credit for something. he said he wants to get credit for something. So everybody that watched the video yesterday that I was talking about that movie, it is Michael that picked it. Okay, baby, you can say something.
Hi, yes, I picked the movie.
Are you happy now?
Yes.
Alrighty, baby, go. He said, I just want to take credit for something. I said, okay, come on, let us stay there, man. Because yesterday, I wanted to watch a movie. He said, Mommy, let me pick a movie for us to watch. So he picked that Miracles from Heaven. He said, I know you will love this one. Because me, I like those kind of movies where you can learn something, where you can see the power of God moving. So my son already knows me. So he was like, I didn't tell my followers that he was him that picked it. Oh my God, that was so funny. Oh my God, that was funny. So now he has, everybody knows Michael. Michael picked that movie for us to watch. That boy is something else. Okay, so I was talking about this lady that called me towards the end of in 2016 when I first started preaching. And was just telling me how she wants to live for God, how she wants God to change her life and everything. And while she was talking, God was speaking to me. I could just hear a name. I kept hearing the name. I couldn't take it no more. I had to ask her. I said, who is Emeka? Who is Emeka? She said, that's like one of my ex-boyfriend that really hurt me, you know, and all that stuff. That she has blocked him everywhere, on her Facebook, on her phone, and everything. Sorry, this week is a new week. I just wore today, so I'm not really feeling it. Pardon me when you see me moving it anyhow. You guys know that these wigs are just wigs. They're not my real hair. So some of you that will see me moving, they're like, what? She just moved her hair. You're going to be all right. So she was like, well, the guy hurt her so bad and everything. I said, I'm hearing that you need to forgive him. She was like, she doesn't know. She doesn't want to get in contact with that guy anymore. That she blocked him. That she doesn't even want to talk to that guy again. I said, but why would I be hearing that you need to forgive him? I said, I don't know you from nowhere before. I'm just hearing this. This is what God is telling me to tell you to do. And now told her, I say, when you finish doing that, this is an assignment. When you do it, oh, somebody say, somebody watched the movie. You guys did the assignment I gave you. You went to go watch the movie. Charlene says, I watched it this morning and I can't stop crying. Oh, you like the movie? God bless all of you. Hallelujah. I'm glad my son picked a good movie. Let's see if he will pick another one. I don't know. I don't always want to watch movie, but whenever I want to watch, it has to be a good one. So she was not like, I said, well, when you go and you call him or you find a way to reach him and you forgive him, you can let me know because this is what I'm hearing. This girl wanted to be filled with the presence of God. She wanted to fulfill her destiny. Like, I even prophesied to her. I told her, I see her preaching and all these things. And she said, yeah, people have been telling her she has a calling, but she doesn't know what to do. She doesn't know anything. That I said, well, let's start with this one. So she now looked for a way to get in contact with the guy. I think she unblocked his number. She obeyed immediately. Good lady. I've not even talked to this lady since, but God brought her story to me to tell you guys for a reason. She called this guy like maybe around 10 at night or 11. I don't know. And when she called this guy, she said the guy was like, oh my God. Wow. Oh my God. Somebody say, what movie, please? God bless you. Some of you didn't watch it yesterday. It's called, can somebody type the name of the movie? Miracles from Heaven. It's called Miracles from Heaven. Miracles from Heaven. Very good movie. So she said, oh my God. Oh my God. The guy could not believe it. The guy was, oh, Temi, you were there then. God bless you, Temi. Temi has been watching me for a long time. She remembers this. Oh my God. You see, I like when these old timers are still watching. They remember these stories so that you guys will know that the stories never change. They are still the same. You see, the guy was like, oh my God, that he has been praying throughout that year that if God can let this woman answer his call or call him to, like he wants to apologize to her, that's his major prayer point for that whole year. Because he believed that he really hurt her and he's been feeling bad about it. So he made it a prayer point. He said if God can make this woman call to forgive him, that he will give a testimony that he has changed, but he still feels bad because he did not like the way he treated her. And she has blocked him everywhere. Every time he tries to call her with anything, he was like, oh my God, God really answers prayers. The guy was screaming. The guy was happy. He was like, I can't believe you actually called me. I am sorry. He was just apologizing. He said, in fact, this is the best thing that has happened to me this year. Do you understand the importance of forgiveness? The guy was so happy. She did not know he would be that happy. She was still having the anger from, you know how a boyfriend would treat a girl so bad and maybe dump her or maybe cheat on her. I don't know what the story was, but some of you still have grudge from your ex-boyfriend. Even though now you are married, though, you still see an ex-boyfriend in the past and you still get angry at them. For what? You're already married. You've moved on. Even if you haven't moved on, forgive them. Don't be carrying grudge from a past relationship, because sometimes it affects your current relationship. Because of unforgiveness from the previous relationship, you now pour the anger on the new guy or the new woman. Guess what? The guy was so happy. He said that's all he wanted. That he made it a prayer point telling God that if this woman can forgive him, that he will be happy. That he really hurt her so bad. For a man to say that he really hurt somebody, that means he himself, he did not know why he was doing that to her. It was a strong force making him to do that to her. You understand what I mean? Because sometimes when men have spirit wife or the woman have spirit husband, you see them treating people anyhow in the relationship. And you will tag this person as a bad boy. He's a cheat. He sleeps around. It is a spirit that is doing it to him, making him do this. Forgive him. Lead him to where he can get deliverance. You understand what I mean? It's not really there. So guess what? She now forgave the guy. When she forgave the guy, it was too late. Right? She now went into her room or somewhere and was just trying to pray, you know, just trying to pray. Because she said she felt like something had left her, because she did not know the guy would sound so happy. She did not know the guy would own up to everything he did. She just did not know that the conversation would go like that. So she was just happy that at least, thank God, this chapter is closed. I can now have peace, because it was troubling her too. She just had hatred for him. It's not like they are coming back together. It's not the point. The point is somebody needed to forgive somebody. Do you know what happened? She said around 1 a.m. that morning, 2 hours after that incident with she and the guy, she said suddenly she started speaking in tongues. Suddenly, it's like a strong presence of God came to her house. She spoke in tongues from, was it 11 p.m.? Tell me, you remember. I don't know if it was 11 p.m. to 5 a.m. in the morning. She says she spoke in tongues. She had a book full of things that God told her. She was just writing things. For the first time, she started to hear God clearly. She was writing things. She was speaking in tongues. She said till 5:30. Oh, I have that in my album. If you go to my testimony album, go to the very first set of testimonies. You will see it. She said, you told me to forgive. I forgave. And the Spirit of God came, took over me from almost 6 hours. She was speaking in tongues, crying. She said, I was just writing. God was just telling me so many things. I was just writing. I didn't pray for her. I just told her, this is what I'm hearing God say you should go and do. The moment she obeyed and she did it, oh my God, her destiny started to change. See, her destiny got restored. That was not the end of it. That girl became a prophetess. That girl can hear from God. That girl can prophesy. She's always watching my video. I don't know if she's there now. I think I saw her yesterday watching. Do you know, just 2 weeks ago or so, I was browsing Facebook. And I started seeing how she posts testimonies, like the way I post testimonies. how people are calling her woman of God now, how she will pray and it happens, how she will tell people things and it happens. And I started smiling. I was like, oh my God, look at this girl. God is using her. Because I know what I saw when I was prophesying, when I was praying to her. I'm not really a prophetess, but sometimes when we're in the spirit, we say things, right? I remember telling her that I see her, God using her mightily and all that stuff. And she was always joining our fasting. She was always praying with us. I think she still joins today. I don't know, because I don't talk to her much. But I still see her on my videos all the time. I was reading testimonies that this girl had posted. People were getting healed. Things she would tell people was happening. Aha! And not only that, I saw a flyer. She was put on the flyer as prophetess with her name. Not in America, outside the country, somewhere in London or somewhere. Hey! I said, my God, look at how God has changed this woman's life. You understand? Like, I was so happy for her. I said, I remember the first day she called me, worried, wondering about her life. It took one phone call to forgive somebody. One phone call to forgive somebody. And I didn't have to pray for her. That was just what was blocking her from hearing from God. That was blocking her from getting filled with the Holy Ghost. It was just blocking so many things because the guy, according to him, he hurt her so bad. She blocked his number everywhere. Blocked him everywhere. Did not want to even hear his name. Even when I said his name, asking who he is, she was not happy. She's like, that's an ex that I don't want to have any dealings with, that one. That one really hurt me. Da, da, da. She let go. And God took over. And now she's traveling everywhere. I saw her on a flyer. Preaching. Preaching. She's supposed, they call that prophetess on the fly. Let me see if I can find it. I was so happy for her. I said, my God, what if she had refused to forgive? What if she had said, no, that's a closed chapter. I don't want to. She did not know it was the boy's prayer point. She had no idea that it was his prayer point. If only this woman can call me. If only she can call me. And forgive me. Oh, I will be so happy, Lord. All the way. Look at that. Look at the flyer. She was with other men of God, other women of God on it. This is her here. They call that prophetess. Look at her here. The one at the end. Prophetess Chi Chi USA. I was so happy for her. I said, look at somebody's life, oh, has changed. Like, it's like when you see people and how God is using them, because God wants to use a lot of people. God is not going to use only me, I can't do the work. There are many churches. In fact, in your neighborhood or where your church is, there's probably like 10 other churches not too far from each other. Are you going to be the only one to preach in all those 10 churches? Are you going to be the only one to preach in Nigeria, in America? No. You can't be hating on people when God is using them. God wants to use a lot of people. You will be happy for them. You will support them. Because they are doing the work of our Father. The harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. This ministry, I have seen so many people, ladies especially, even guys too. One even sent a picture one time of how he preached in the church. When I was telling him he will preach, he was he couldn't believe it. He was laughing. When it happened, he sent me a picture of it. This was like last year. Let me see if I can find his name. Oh, what is his name? Oh, my God. Hold on, guys. I want to find his name. I think I'll have that picture. I posted it. He was preaching. He said he preached. Oh, man. I don't have it. I went to the chat of me and him from that time to see if the picture will be there, but I don't see it. He shared a picture of him preach. Oh, look at it. I found it. Yeah. Look at him. Preach it. And he said, the Spirit of God. Oh, let me see. Oh, my God. Hold on. I want to see what he said. This was since last year. This was July to 31st of 2017. He said, yesterday was my first preaching in the church. My message is now the talk of the city. He lives in, is it Germany or somewhere? Sweden? I don't know. It's somewhere. He says, yesterday was my first preaching in the church. My message is now the talk of the city. Because the Holy Spirit took an awesome control. Thank you, Ma, for the revelation and decree upon my life. Decree that you made upon my life. This is it. This is the message. Like, I have seen people change. People that when I tell them, God is telling me you will be a pastor. Some of them will laugh at me. I say, I see you preaching. I see you doing this. I see you. Before you know it, when they get filled. See, me, when I lay hands on you, or when I speak a word over your life, or when I pray over it, it's not just me, any anointed person, just even my bishop, even my cousin. When an anointed person decrees something over your life, and you believe it, you receive it, or they lay hands on you, your life can never be the same unless you want it to be the same. Unless you are not going to go grow that thing that they put inside of you. Unless you are just going to let it die like that. When I got filled with the Holy Ghost, I stayed in my closet daily, spending hours in His presence, reading the Word, preaching on Facebook. There were so many of us that got filled with the Holy Ghost that day. But I don't think everybody is where they are supposed to be, because it depends on you. What did you do to maintain it? What did you do to grow it? Did you obey all the instructions? Me, I even gave up my car. I told you guys, when Bishop called 5 of us out in the last training he did for the church, that these 5 people, God wants them to sow a seed that will, a very strong seed or something. And then he will just take them to another level in ministry. I heard clearly my car. That was the only thing I had. I had lost everything in my storage. I gave my car without looking back. I gave my car without looking back. I followed every instruction. Because I believed in the man of God that God had placed me with. Some of you, God will send you to a woman of God. And she will be saying something. You will be getting mad. You won't want to believe that God is speaking through her. You will start letting the devil telling you, why are you listening to this one? Why are you doing this? I believed and I obeyed. And just a few weeks ago, I got a car just like God promised me. I don't even drive it much. I don't really go anywhere. Do you understand what I mean? Like, lives change. If you want it to change, there's some people, they've been watching you for years. Nothing is changing in their life because they're not doing anything about it. They just come in the video and sit down there and hear you, but they don't take action. They don't do anything. You tell them, call this one to forgive, as I'm preaching about forgiveness now. Some of you are supposed to be texting people, calling people, saying, I'm sorry. I forgive you. I love you. God bless you. I don't want to go to hell. Please. What you did to me is not that serious anyway. I still have life. I'm still alive. I forgive you. I want you to watch this lady, or I want to invite you to church. Just do what you gotta do. Let it go. But some of you, you will still be holding on to that thing. You will say, what is she saying? Because that it happened for that lady doesn't mean it will happen for me. I'm not doing it. I'm not. How would you change? I can only do my part. I can only bridge. But I cannot do your part for you. I cannot do the part that God wants you to do. I cannot pray for you all the time. You have to pray for yourself. You have to have that relationship with God. I cannot be the one to spend 2 hours speaking in tongues for you. You have to do that part. Sometimes when that lady messages me, the one I just showed you a picture on the flyer, she'll say, woman of God, I prayed in tongues for hours today. I couldn't stop. When I do 12 hours speaking in tongues, 6 hours, that lady was always on the prayer line. And she would just be getting revelation. She always used to write it. She'll say, if you see my book, I have so many things that I've written. I have so many things that God has to. She's not the only one. I have so many ladies. Even some people that came through me, that God told me to tell them some things, that they started preaching. One of them, she and her husband, before you know, they started insulting me. They made a video of me insulting me. You cannot be making video insulting the one that God sent to help you. You already know where that will go. But that's fine. That's okay. That's how they want to roll. But the fact is, lives have changed. People that want to change. See, when you see a ministry where lives are changing, you know God is there. When you see a ministry that is so full of talk, But nothing is changing with anyone in that ministry. Hey, you know, the devil doesn't change your life to be good. If anything, it changes your life to be bad. It makes you evil. You understand what I mean? He doesn't want you to progress. He doesn't want you to fulfill your destiny. You don't understand? When you see a ministry where people, even some of you now, preach somewhere, maybe Facebook, or maybe somewhere on the street, or maybe in your church. Some of you now that before, you couldn't even sing. Now you are in the choir. Now you are leading worship. Now your life has changed. Maintain it. Keep the fire burning. Keep doing what you're doing. Don't stop. Because let me tell you something. The moment you stop, the moment you slow down, the fire will quench. It's just like a lamp, a lantern or something. You keep putting kerosene. Or you keep putting, you understand what I mean? Kerosene for the fire to keep burning. If you don't put kerosene for a few days, the fire will go off. You guys know what a lantern is, right? I don't know if you guys know it. You know me, I'm Niger woman, so. If you have that lantern, you keep pouring kerosene into it, and the fire will stay burning. If you forget to put kerosene, maybe for one day, it will still burn. It will still be on. 2 days, it might still be on, but if up to a few days, you don't put kerosene in it, the fire will eventually go out. It will eventually quench. I'm telling you, this is how it is with the anointing. You have to keep it burning. Like all these daily videos that I do, Jesus even said that we should carry our cross daily and follow him. Don't care what anybody say about you. Keep this your fire burning. If you feel, if your own is to worship every day for 1 hour, keep doing it. If your own is to read the Bible every day, keep reading the Bible. If your own is to pray daily, keep praying daily. Don't stop. I'm telling you, don't stop. Whenever some of my followers message me and they are excited about something that God is doing, I always tell them, keep the fire burning. Keep the fire burning. Keep the fire burning. Keep the fire burning. I keep my fire burning. Even when I don't come on Facebook, I'm praying all the time. I'm reading the word. I'm praying for people. I'm doing things that please God. I'm always staying in the presence of God. So my fire will keep burning. Even with men of God, women of God. You can be highly anointed. And for almost a year, you don't do anything about it. Maybe you go take a regular job. You start doing a regular job or something.